around the corner for Christmas. And today, I want to talk about Christmas as a season of giving. Christmas as a season of giving. Jesus, our Father, gave Jesus to us. John chapter 3 verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life." So in this season of giving, what have you decided to give? What are you going to give? Some may say, "Oh, I have nothing to give." But remember the story of that woman who put the 2 drachma coins. She had nothing to give, but she gave the best. The Bible tells us in Luke chapter 6 verse 38, "Give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall man give to your bosom." Are you ready to trust the Lord? Trust the Lord with all your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding, tells Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Because if you lean on your own understanding, you're looking at your purse. But if you lean on the word of God, which says, "Give and it shall be given unto you." Today I encourage you to sow the seed of faith. By faith you can move every mountain. And today is your opportunity, this Christmas season, to really prove to the world that you believe in a Savior. A Savior who has come to redeem you and redeem the whole world. So give something today. Give because Jesus loves you. I'm not asking you to give to this ministry of Upper Room. I'm not asking you to give to anyone that you and I know or something like that. Give to a total stranger. Give to someone because God wants you to give. Give to someone with love in your heart. And that gift that you give will increase, will multiply, and will bring joy to heaven, because there is great rejoicing in heaven over one sinner that repents, brothers and sisters. Please, I request you that this season of Christmas will not go without you giving someone something, and may that what you give, no matter how small, is the seed of faith. It will increase, it will multiply and come back to you and give glory to God. We love you, brothers and sisters, and I take this opportunity once again to wish you a very, very Merry Christmas. Oh, beloved brothers, we will not see you again before Christmas, but we will see you definitely after Christmas. God bless you, and a Merry, Merry, Merry Christmas to you all.